Russell to A. Brown, all ready to go. Another big day of championship wrestling, David.
Oh, we're going to go today with the King, Jerry Lawler, here in the opening match of the day.
In the ring.
That's right.
Seeing the world heavyweight champion in action.
Right here. Also, a little bit later on, Robert Fuller, the Tennessee stud, will be here. Jeff Jarrett will be here in a match against Gary Young on, too. And we've got a tag team match. It should be a goodie. Phil Hickerson and Brickhouse Bunkhouse Brown on one side of the ring. On the other, it'll be Billy Travis and Scott Steiner.
Southern Tag Champs.
That's
it'll be a non-title bout, but boy, what a match that is. And I'm telling you, we got a lot of other features. We got some tapes that we're going to be showing you I think you'll really enjoy. In order to do it, we better get at it right now. We'll be back in just a moment with more action. I'm talking about the world heavyweight champion, Jerry the King Lawler. But before he gets in the ring, we're going to bring him on around. Well, I'll tell you, we've had too many Saturdays here where too many times for championship wrestling where the King has not been able to be with us. Look at that big, bright, shining belt. And we are delighted that he is able to make it in today. Jerry, welcome to championship wrestling.
Well, Lance, it is a pleasure to be here. You know, there was a time, of course, when I was just just like yourself, permanent fixture out here.
I loved it.
But, of course, since winning the title, there's been an awful lot of traveling involved, and it's taken me away from here. You know, I haven't been able to be out here as much as I would like to, but as I told everybody before I won this title, that if I was successful in getting this belt, I was going to do my best. You know, I knew there would be a lot of obligations, a lot of traveling, but I was going to do my best to bring as many world title matches right here in this area as I possibly could, and I think that so far the people have to agree that I've been able to do that. We brought a lot of contenders right in here, and of course I've had to go out and wrestle a lot of them, but what I've missed being able to do is be here on television and wrestle. And so of course last week I saw that I had a Saturday morning open, so I called Eddie Marlin and I called Randy Hales and I asked them if they would let me come and wrestle on TV one more time, just for old times.
We'll give you a tryout here and see if you make it up to the caliber.
Who am I wrestling, you, Dave, or what? Come on, Dave, world title match, I'll give you one right now. But anyway, I'm looking forward to it, Lance, and you know, I do also want to say that I want to thank the people that are...
Come on, Phil, listen.
I want to say something to you, Jerry Lawler. Let me tell you something. You stand out here and you just told one of the biggest lies. I bet you're listening that he has been trying to bring all his championship material in here and everywhere else to run it. That is a bald-faced lie, Lawler. That's a lie. If these geeks out here believe it, and if you believe it, it's a lie. For years, this belt right here has been the number one contender for the world title shot, and here it is. I've got it, and you won't give me a title shot. Now, why won't you give me a title shot? We have never been on a one-on-one situation. Why don't you give the CWA a title shot if that belt's yours? Why? Tell me. Are you scared of me, Lawler? Are you scared of me? Because you know I can beat you.
Bill, we don't need to settle this out here now. You can tell us other times to do this.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you close your yap long enough and let me tell you why. First of all, I'm not the one who determines who I wrestle or when I wrestle. The championship, the AWA Championship Committee is the group that gets together, and they're the ones that look around the country and determine who the top contenders are. They're the ones who line up the matches for me. All they do is send me a schedule of places to be and a list of wrestlers to wrestle against. And so far, you're right. Your name has not appeared on that list, and as you said, always, for as long as I've known, the CWA Southern title holder was one of the top contenders. But obviously, Phil, now that you have the belt, the championship committee must take a look and say, well, this big fat slob from Jackson really is not worthy of a title match.
You right now, man.
No, there's not going to be any fighting out here.
Come out here, man. You run what?
I'll tell you what, Phil. You know, that's one thing that Lance has always said about Phil Hickerson. He's from Jackson, Tennessee, and he loves to fight, right?
That's right.
Well, let me tell you something, Phil Hickerson. I'm from Memphis, Tennessee, and I like a good fight just as well as anybody else. So if you just want to fight, why don't we get in the ring with
him? I want a title shot.
Stable and bring it out here.
Title shot, Lawler.
Got five of you out here. Maybe something a little different. five with you guys. Makes a whole different story.
Now, Hickerson, just as usual, you always got that stable to back you up. Well, as you can see, other people got friends, too. So let your stable stay out here. We'll let my friends stay out here. If you still want to fight, let's fight.
Come on. Well, I can... Well, okay, you're going to decline it. I thought Robert Fuller and Jeff Jarrett were going to get into it before anybody else got into it. So the stud stable retreats. They beat a hasty retreat. And just as soon as, well, let's see if we can get an opponent out here. Just as soon as the sides became even 5-on-5, kind of changed the picture in there just a little bit.
Certainly did.
Okay, here, David.
Here comes the opponent for the King right now. Out of Memphis, Tennessee, at 216 pounds, Keith Eric, and going against him in a non-title match, the world heavyweight champion from Memphis, Tennessee, at 238 pounds, the King, Jerry Lawler. Jerry Calhoun, the referee, calls for the bell. Keith Eric telling the crowd, I'm going to beat the world champion right here. Just watch.
Well, this is not the first time they've been in there.
That's true.
I'll tell you, we have seen Keith Eric give Jerry Lawler a very hard way to go.
Boy, I recall one match right here on TV when Eric jumped Lawler. It ended up costing him the match because he made Lawler mad, but the King was in trouble for a few minutes there. Well, it doesn't look like he's in trouble today. He shoved Eric back across the ring.
Well, as we've often said, it's amazing what having a title will do in terms of confidence. Not that Jerry was ever lacking in it because of the experience that he had, but when you are the world heavyweight champion, boy, I'll tell you, it makes a whole world of difference. Uh-oh. Look at Eric. Firing away at the world heavyweight champion. And a whip reverse. Hip tossed him out and a drop kick. And Keith Eric down on the floor.
Keith Eric holding the front of his face there as the King showed him what it's all about here, the wrestle world champion. Eric.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, pulls Lawler's feet out from under him and pulls him out of the ring down on the floor. Lawler ducks out of the way and Keith Eric's fist hit the ring post. Lawler back in the ring. The referee tolling the count on it. He grabs Eric, helps him back through the rope, takes him over and down. Lawler up on the middle rope. Here he comes. Right hand. He covers. One, two, three. Got him. 2 minutes even the time on it. A victory for the King.
There it is. The King. Making a rare appearance since he has the title right here on our championship wrestling. And boy, I'll tell you what, a determined Keith Eric found out that there's some determination on the other side of the fence, too.
Plenty
the...
of it, yes, sir.
We got plenty more of it where that came from, and we're going to be back with it in just a moment.
Like it coming into Evansville. I'm talking about Wednesday night, but and what I mean, a great card at regular prices that's going to be headlined by a six-person tag match. Now, you ready for this? Listen, it'll be Robert Fuller, Jimmy Golden, and Miss Sylvia on one side of the ring, and on the other side of the ring, Jeff Jarrett, Candy Devine, and the superstar, Bill Dundee. Yeah, that's right. You're going to see them all in that one match. Now, in addition to that, a CWA heavyweight championship match, when Phil Hickerson will put it up for grabs, and he didn't think he's got a challenge, but believe me, Billy Travis will show him just exactly what kind of challenge he's going to have. Plenty of other matches that I'll get to a little bit later on, but I want to right now turn it over to Bill Dundee, the tough little Aussie, who will tell you about that six-person match coming up at Evansville Coliseum. I guess this is 1988, and you can't say it has to be a six-person match today. It used to be a six-man, but when you have a woman there, you can't say it's man, woman, whatever they call it, a person. Some of them women libbers, women out there get mad at you. Well, to me, brother, it's just a six-man tag, because, Sylvia, if you get in front of my face, I'm going to punch your lights out. Now, you all just saw what Jeff Jarrett done to you. He whooped that little dress up around your ears and whooped that little fanny with a belt. Now, I'm just going to tell you something, lady. I don't like ladies in the wrestling because there's no ladies in it. I think Candy the Vine's a little bit more lady than you are. But just let me tell you something, girl. If you get up in my face, I ain't whooping your little fanny with no belt. I'm punching your lights out. And Jimmy Golden, Tennessee Stud, Robert Fuller, you know what the superstar can do. Now, we're not coming here to get embarrassed. I don't get embarrassed very often. It's not going to be in Evansville, because I like coming to Evansville, Indiana. And I'm just going to tell all you nice folks out there, I'm going to punch Sylvia's lights out if she gets in front of me. And Robert Fuller and Jimmy Golden, the superstar, and Jeff Jarrett's taking care of you. We'll see you 400 Court Street.
You better be there Wednesday night, the Coliseum. Incident took place during this past week that... I don't guess we have to, but we have to share with all the people out there. This was in a match. Jeff Jarrett finally, after all of the pounding that he had received from Sylvia with that kendo stick, well, let me just run the tape, and it speaks louder than words. Take a look. And there, Bruno being whipped by Jerry Jarrett. Jeff Jarrett being nailed hard by... took place, as a matter of fact. We want to get him out here. There's a guy that finally got a little payback in there. Jeff, you were stroking away for all the fans who wanted that to happen.
Yeah, Lance. You know, I sat back there and watched that monitor. And, you know, I couldn't help but think all the things that Fuller had done to me. Coke bottles, chairs, chains, pile drivers. And then finally a broken arm. And, you know, quite honestly, I'd just like to thank all the fans for sticking beside me and keeping hope and faith in that I could do anything. But last week, boy, it sure did make me feel good to get that belt and tan her, Heine. And Sylvia, I just want to tell you a few things. That's not the last you're going to see of that belt. If you get around that ring, inside it, outside it, I don't care. You're going to get another good whipping. And if you don't like it, you can just stay home. Right?
Sound like a pretty good solution right there.
Yes, sir. And now, Robert, I'm talking to you. Yeah, I did feel good last week doing that, but I don't feel like I've accomplished anything. I don't feel like that I've really overcome anything. Now, Robert Fuller, you did an awful lot to me, but when I will feel satisfied is when you go through the pain, Robert. When you walk up, when you walk to sit down at your dinner table and you can't even pick up your fork. Or when you go to sign a check, you can't even write your name because of the pain you put me through. Robert, someday I'm going to get you in the right place at the right time. Yeah, just like I was, right there, right over there in that place, Robert. I'm going to get you in the right place at the right time, and I'm going to make you feel that pain. Robert, I'll see you at ringside.
Don't believe that's all over with. We're ready for some action right now as we've got a match coming up with a young fella that is starting on his road toward... professional wrestling stardom. We're talking about, well, Dave will give you the official introductions right now.
Right, he's stepping up onto the ringside right now. His opponent's already there from parts unknown at 236 pounds, the assassin. Going against him out of Gallatin, Tennessee at 239 pounds, Cat Garrett. This match, one fall, 15-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun, the referee. Cat Garrett has already gotten a victory, as we pointed out a week so ago. His first appearance in championship wrestling.
Yes,
he got a win.
Cat, quite an athlete. He just always wanted to. He'd watch championship wrestling and a lot of wrestling and always wanted to be a wrestler. And son of a gun, here he is. right today fulfilling at least the first part of his dream. He is in professional wrestling. And, whoa, he got a reversal in, and he reversed the hip toss.
Dad Garrett looking good, keeping his balance. Not an easy thing to do, let me tell you. Looks a lot easier on television than it does when you're standing in the ring with the opponent flying at you like that.
He's a powerful son of a gun, Cat, he is. He's just big through the chest and arms, and his legs are powerful. He was a running back in high school and quite a phenom in the state of Tennessee, as a matter of fact. From Gallatin, I believe.
Yes. Gallatin, Tennessee always seems to be a perennial winner when it comes to high school football. And that's one reason why, right there. Here's a cover by Cat Garrett. Count is two, three, he goes! Boy, he didn't waste any time. He got him down here, pinned those shoulders, and held him for a three count. A minute, 23 seconds, and Cat Garrett has his second victory in a row here on Championship Wrestling.
Yeah, boy, that looks good. We're going to take time. I'll be back with more. We got some great action to go.
I want to give you the entire card coming up in a moment, Wednesday night down at the Coliseum. Listen, you folks around Paoli, Indiana, have had some great championship wrestling right there. It's coming back. September the 8th is the date. That's Paoli, Indiana for championship wrestling, September the 8th. All right, Wednesday, a whole lot closer than that. We're talking about coming up at the Coliseum with Tojo Yamamoto opening up against a newcomer, Ray Odyssey. Then we're going to have gorgeous Gary Young facing Sean Baxter, the big muscle man out of the Motor City. Scott Steiner will be going against Miami's tough Bunkhouse Brown, part of the stud stable. Then a CWA heavyweight title match, and this is going to be tougher than Phil Hickerson thinks. Billy Travis will be the challenger for that match, and stand by for the final bout. Are you ready? Jeff Jarrett, the superstar Bill Dundee, and Candy Devine going against the Tennessee stud Robert Fuller, Jimmy Golden, and Miss Sylvia.
Got Jeff Jarrett and gorgeous Gary Young coming up. We've got a tag match a little bit later with Travis and Steiner going against Hickerson and Brickhouse Brown. All of that coming up, and here is Robert Fuller.
You're looking real fine in your suit and your tie. Do you run this outfit or what?
No.
You're the man that runs this program right here.
No.
Did I come out here last week and ask you personally, face to face, would you play a tape where Jerry Jarrett got his butt whipped but good, britches pulled down to his knees? Did I do that?
Yes, you did.
Bring the people up today down here that don't know it.
Well,
let me ask you something. How come you come up conveniently with a Jeff Jarrett tape, huh?
Well, you wanted a tape. We ran a tape this week. We thought that might make you happy.
Oh,
you griped when we didn't have a tape in there, and now that we have one, you're griping again. Can't please you.
Slick, I know where you're coming from because I listened to you earlier out there. You not only put that tape on, you was jovial about it. You loved it. You like Jeff Jarrett come out here and said, man, big as light and day, man, that he ain't done nothing. He's done something that's gonna get him bad hurt. You better listen to me out there, too. Shut your mouth when I'm talking. Let me tell you something. I came to this area right here with nothing but good intentions. I came in here to work my way up a ladder. That punk jumped me, tied my throat up here in the corner, and beat the fire out of me when I'm tied in the corner. Besides that, I went to the building. That goofy Badian or whatever it is came in the ring with it, threw the garbage can on my leg. 25 stitches on my leg. Is that true?
Yes,
true. You know it's true.
That's true.
You know darn well it's true. He hit me with bottles. That's the start of the thing, man. He hit me with bottles. The man has done everything in the world. And then he come in the ring and took Sylvia. Now, it's one thing, man. You want to misuse a lady. You want to treat a woman bad. But when you pull her dress up like you done, boy, I'm going to tell you right now. I'm going to tell you right now. You can get your butt out here and get it right now. Because what the stud's got for you, son, you bring it out here and get it. You and your daddy and your whole family, your mother and every one of them is a bunch of stinking billy goats. You ain't nothing, man. You don't walk with a big dog. You little bitty dog. I'm 6'5", 250 pounds. I'm an old man. I'm not like you, punk. And nobody goes around doing my fighting. And I'm going to tell you what, son. Just sure as there's night and day. Sure as Sylvia can't come out here and show her face. She can't show her face over this. It's your bad luck, son, because she's the beauty. She's the girl. She's the prettiest thing that ever hit this town. And I'm going to tell you this. You may not be looking at her. You're going to see my pretty face. And you might get sick of it. But you're going to look at it and look at it and look at it until you go, son. Because I figured it out. It's murder or suicide. One of the two. And I ain't into suicide. Get me the pony out here. I want to wrestle.
Robert Fuller, I would not want to be the opponent for Robert Fuller. But
see, I've known Robert Fuller for a long, long time. And I ain't never seen him like this, Lancer. I ain't never seen him this way. So, you know, this Jeff Jarrett's going to have to pay the price, see. You're going to dance to the music, you got to pay to the piper. It's time to pay to the piper, see, because he danced to the music. He thought it was funny. Jarrett thought it was funny. You thought it was funny. Everybody thinks it's so funny, they think it's a joke. Well, we all think it's a joke. The stable doesn't think it's a joke. But see, right here is an example of what's going to happen to Jeff Jarrett. This is an example of what's going to happen to Jerry Jarrett and anybody else that thinks they want to stick their nose into the stable's business, especially humiliating somebody. See, the object of professional wrestling is to beat your opponent in the ring. That's it, baby. That's it, Rob. Get him. See, like I was saying, Lance, before you interrupted me, the object of professional wrestling is to beat your opponent in the ring by out-wrestling him. It's like human chess. You make a move, your opponent makes a move. You out-think him, you out-move him, and you beat him. See, has nothing to do with whipping somebody. See, I got whipped with the belt, too. I hope Sylvia don't feel like no Lone Ranger, because I got whipped with the belt, too. They didn't pull my pants off or anything like that, but they pulled her dress up, and that was humiliating. And we're going to do the same thing, see? The same thing we're going to do. Exactly, Rob, get him. Lance, quit interrupting me. Look here, the same thing that's happening to this Alan Reynolds punk is what's going to happen to anybody that wants to mess with the Tennessee Stud, Robert Fuller. Anybody that's going to mess with the Stud Stable, you understand? Because the Stud Stable is number one, and you don't humiliate the stable. Here's an example of what's going to happen. One,
that's
two, three.
A three, one, two, three, and Robert Fuller went in there with a vengeance, and I am here to tell you, boy, he ate Alan Reynolds alive, Dave.
He sure did. A minute 16 was the time of the match, and he could have beat him at least once and probably two or three times before. But he refused to go ahead with a three count at that point because he said he wasn't through with him yet.
Well, boy, I'll guarantee you one thing. He flat poured it on at Robert Fuller, steaming mad, as he ended up with a very convincing victory over Alan Reynolds. Right now, we want you to take a look at a videotape that tells all about the road to the gold. I'm talking about Jerry Lawler's ascension to the World Heavyweight Championship. Here it is.
From the beginning of his career, through all his battles, all the many wars, all but one title was his, the World Heavyweight Championship. Now, facing the stipulation of retirement, he would journey to the ring to face yet his greatest challenge. Jerry Lawler, the King, the Challenger. Kurt Hennig, the reigning AWA World Champion. And special referee, the legendary Jackie Fargo. Now, the most talked about championship match is the most exciting video cassette ever. The battle for the belt. It's all here. The interviews, the entrances, the main events, and the press conference that follows. 60 minutes of true Memphis magic. The night the King climbed the mountain for all the world to see. The crown of a new world champion. And what an unbelievable TV offer. If you act now, you'll receive free with your cassette a copy of this 20-page edition of the Warrior Report. The same one sold at the Coliseum that night. It's loaded with action photos and an exclusive interview with the King himself. Plus, as an added bonus, you'll also receive this magnificent full-color poster of the King at no extra charge. Order now. To order by credit card, call 1-800-321-4100. If ordering by mail, send $29.95 plus $3 shipping to Road to the Championship Video, P.O. Box 3020, Cherry Hill, New Jersey, 08034. Sorry, no CODs or VEDAs. Allow 4 weeks for delivery.
For a one-fall, 15-minute time limit match out of Little Rock, Arkansas. 245 pounds, gorgeous Gary Young. Downtown Bruno's in his corner. And going against him from Hendersonville, Tennessee, at 208 pounds, Jeff Jarrett. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Referee, Jerry Calhoun.
As soon as we get Bruno out, we might get the match underway. Belton, here we go, and this is a dandy. We have got a great single match going here with Jeff Jarrett facing gorgeous Gary Young. Just remember also that we've got a sensational tag match yet to come with Billy Travis and Scott Steiner go against a couple of the other stud stables, Phil Hickerson and Bunkhouse Brown. All of that yet to come here on Championship Wrestling.
Can I say something? You're going to talk all day. I just want to make a comment about this little short fella named Bill Dundee. You know, I didn't realize that they were going to sign a midget match, you know, in the CWA. But wait a minute.
He found himself on the floor there while Bruno's over here running his mouth. Gary Young got tossed out of the ring by Jeff Jarrett.
Whoa! You better be over there helping your boy, Bruno.
No, no help. He's just letting the guy build up some confidence so he can beat him. See, he's getting a false sense of security. But Lance, before you interrupted me, I was saying, I didn't know they allowed midget matches in the CWA. But apparently they do, because this Bill Dundee's coming back to life. But this little short fella, see, he goes around, he's got that hair, it's dyed black. It's not natural blue black like mine is, because everybody knows mine's natural blue black. I've never had a mustache or a beard. I've always had sideburns like I do right now, see. Always, Lancer. You know, I've always worn the jumpsuits, always worn the boots, always wore the glasses, always wore the chains and the rings.
Good night.
He don't need my help.
Young pitched him straight up in the air, and Jeff Jarrett right down on his face.
Lancer, that's why he's part of the stable. That's why I'm out here with him. He don't need my help at ringside, because he don't need me to cheat or distract or whatever, because he can do it himself. Look at that.
Again. Jeff Jarrett hurled straight up in the air by gorgeous Gary Young.
Lance, just one comment I was going to make. Remember, I am the true superstar professional wrestler. Just call me Superstar Downtown Bruno from now on, because that is exactly what I am, is a superstar. The key to the match in the ring. You know, Jeff Jarrett, see, he's always got the advantage when he's got Jerry Jarrett at ringside. Because, see, Jerry Jarrett, he's what you call the typical interfering, distracting manager. He's always tripping somebody or throwing somebody a foreign object, distracting the referee so Jeff can cheat, you know, some way or another. Boom. I know, Lancer. It goes without saying. Gordon Jerry is visually brutal, see? And he can do it. But see, he hasn't had that distraction because Jerry Jarrett isn't running around ringside, being a thorn in his side, you know what I mean? But see, I don't have to do that as a manager because my brother can sit down.
Sunset. But that's all they could get out of it is Gary whipped him in. Jeff came off with a sunset flip. Young was getting ready for a backdrop, and he did the sunset flip on him, but he could only get a one count. Look at Gary Young. He catapults him right into that top turnbuckle, and Jarrett back down and hurt, but he's close to the ropes. He'll never get the count. He got the shoulder up.
Lance, let me tell you something. For everybody, the sunset flip, see, that was just a minor miscalculation on Gary's part, and you can see he rectified it real quick. And for those of you that don't think that I've got a superior knowledge of professional wrestling, let me tell you, the sunset flip is called the rolling reverse cradle. Oh yeah, baby, that's the name of the sunset flip. For those of us that know a little something about this sport.
Oh, okay,
Bruno. Yeah. So you probably wouldn't know that.
I'm happy with sunset flip. One, two, and Jeff Jarrett kicks out. As he finally got it up, boy, I was getting worried there, Davey. Looked like he was gone.
He was very close to that three count, no doubt about it.
Why would you worry? When Gary Young was playing with that sunset flip, you wasn't worried. You didn't talk about being worried. What are you talking about? You're worried. I want to know, Lance. What is it?
Maybe because you irritate me. That's why, Downtown Bruno.
Oh,
maybe that.
I'm going to walk away.
Oh, okay.
Jeff had him hooked, took him down in a small package, but couldn't hold the shoulders down for a three count. There's that high knee.
Boy, I mean high knee. He popped it to him. No, it's a two count.
Shoulder got you on the count.
Two count, not a three count. Gorgeous Gary Young rips a right hand to the side of Jeff Jarrett, takes a big right to the midsection. Rolling down on the 5-minute mark. Jeff coming back, pounding to the midsection, but Gary Young
Got him in the eyes.
Goes to the eyes.
Jeff Jarrett really making a nice comeback. Looked like he had things about ready to be turned around his way. Gary Young caught him right across the eyes. Got him back into the turnbuckles with a broad arm. Now whip into the turnbuckles across the way. And Young goes in there after him. Gary Young hammering Jeff Jarrett.
He's heading down with two. Ooh, and Jarrett is out of the way, and Young slams into the turnbuckle. Gary went to the well himself one too many times. Pounds Jarrett down across with a big broad arm. Scoops him. Body slam.
Young over in the corner, climbing the rope. He's on the top one. Elite. Jeff is gone when he got there. I guess Bruno considered that a minor miscalculation.
Minor miscalculation. Certainly. Wham! And Jeff Jarrett swinging a big right hand at Gary Young. Again. Shovels him in and backdrops him out of there.
Jeff Jarrett running his head into the turnbuckle over there. Now Young whipped across the way. Reversal. Oh, the referee involved in that one. Jeff reversed corners, and the referee was back in that corner. Jeff's got a cover. Look out. Here comes Bunkhouse Brown. Elbow across the back of the neck. He picks Jeff up by the hair. Jeff saw downtown Bruno over by this corner, so he reversed the momentum of Young. Jeff moves out of the way. There's a cover again by Jeff. Referee counts one, two. He got it.
He got it.
Jeff Jarrett beats three of them. Gary Young, Bunkhouse Brown, and the ever-distracting downtown Bruno over in the corner. 7 minutes, 3 seconds. What a match.
Brown had what looked like some knucks on his hand, too, when he came off of there. So when Jeff got out of the way, I am here to tell you, he flat-nailed gorgeous Gary Young. And now look at Young. He's putting it on Bunkhouse about it. Uh-oh.
Look out.
Little difficulty in the stable. Brickhouse.
Who broke up,
gets a pin, attempted pin, ended up when he came off that rope, nailed gorgeous Gary Young, and Gary Young is hot, boiling about it.
Boy,
jumps down on the floor.
Ooh.
Downtown Bruno trying to keep them separated. Let's not take a break just a second. I want to see this.
Ooh, Bruno, thrown by Gary Young.
Boy, Young is scheming. Look out.
Here comes Hickerson. Hickerson gets
Bill
it. Hickerson. Oh, Young swinging, trying to swing around Phil Hickerson. That's not easy to do. Hickerson is saying, all right, settle down, both of you. Trouble in the stud stable.
Yeah, I guess.
Been some trouble there before, too.
Uh-huh. Seen other signs of it too. As gorgeous Gary Young was ready to take Bunkhouse's head off in there. He ended up nailing Young when Jarrett got out of the way. Phil Hickerson comes out. He's the peacemaker. He's explaining to Young it was just a mistake that happened in there. And Brickhouse is trying to say, hey, I didn't mean to hit you. If you'd have held him.
Trying to help.
Yeah. So with Hickerson and downtown Bruno, they're trying to solve it, settle it down right here. But it looks like maybe that a little troubled water is flowing through the seas of the stud stable as Phil Hickerson had to come out to keep Gary Young and Bunkhouse from slamming each other's teeth out. Gary Young puts a hand out to shake hands and say, let's make it up. And Bunk Brockhouse feels like he's being picked on, and he's not so sure he wants to be a friend of gorgeous Gary Young anyhow. They shake hands, and Hickerson stopped what was a bad riff in the stadium.
You can't make anything out of it. There's no distinction going on, man.
Oh, no distinction.
None whatsoever. The stable is still stable, brother.
I hear it, Phil. Keep on talking. We'll take time out. We'll be back in a minute.
Going to be taken by
a minute. I got some stuff to tell you right now too, Lussell. You need to listen to me a second, because I'm going to tell you something, make it very clear that when you come out there, son, and figure for 1 second you can abuse a lady like you did Sylvia, you're totally wrong. But when you come out there and you start getting sexual perverted in your mind, pull your britches up off of her tail to whip her, that's when it stops right there. And I'm going to say something to you, and I'm going to get it straight to you too, son. I tried to hurt you. I tried hard. But I'm going to get the job done come Wednesday night, and ain't nothing going to stop me, Bill Dundee or nobody else. That's the bad news. Now for the good news, let's get it settled. You're not going to have myself and Jimmy out there against the three of those. That Sylvia's going to be there. And I know what you're thinking out there. You're figuring, well, if Candy Devine's a former world champion. I can promise you some former world champion, just like that punk Jarrett, go pay his dues. You're going to pay your dues for ever signing a contract to wrestle in a goofy six-man tag like that. I'm out of the
gym. I'm going to tell you, she must be crazy there, Tennessee Stud, because she's stepping in the ring with danger, brother. I've whooped me a lot of men before, but I ain't never been able to have me a chance to whip no lady. Well, but you, Candy Devine, well, I guarantee she's going to get it kicked, well, right along with the rest of them dogs, because you're in the ring with two dogs as your partner. We're going to take care of business.
Yeah, well, we'll find out Wednesday night, and don't think that Candy Devine is going to be in there unprotected. Jeff Jarrett, Bill Dundee, Candy Devine going against the Tennessee Stud, Robert Fuller, Big Jimmy Golden, and Miss Sylvia. That's just one of the matches. In addition to that, a CWA Heavyweight Championship match definitely will be a sparkler when Phil Hickerson puts it on the line against Billy Travis. Wednesday night, regular prices. Come on, be with us. A lot of requests for the video of the week. This week, Jeff Jarrett.
Team action coming up here. Here comes the referee.
Talking about.
Yeah, this should be a good one here. Hey, this should be interesting. We've got Bunkhouse Brown, Phil Hickerson coming out here. With downtown Bruno in their corner. And now, Mr. Steiner is headed to the ring along with Billy Travis. This is going to be a tag team match to the expiration of time. Total weight 504 pounds with Phil Hickerson and Bunkhouse Brown. You may know him as Brickhouse Brown. Across the way, total 478 pounds out of Detroit, Michigan, Scott Steiner. And out of Lexington, Kentucky, Billy Travis. This match to the expiration of time. Gary Calhoun, the referee, and as soon as we get the signal, we will be off and running with the tag team match of the day.
Bell time, and here we go. Phil the Peacemaker and Bunkhouse Brown teaming together. I don't think we've ever seen these two together as a tag team.
I don't recall. I don't think we have at all. Phil was the one that, I guess, Bunkhouse may not have been a partner for Phil Hickerson had things kept going the way they did earlier. Gary Young and Bunkhouse almost getting into it and having a falling out there. Phil Hickerson came out and got things settled down.
Good surprise move by Billy Travis as he went down and took Bunkhouse up. The referee was not there to start the count immediately. He wouldn't have gotten him anyhow, but it was just an interesting move as Travis goes to head scissors, but Brown kicks his way out of it. Billy Travis and Scott Steiner do hold the Southern Tag Team titles. This is not, however, a title match. This is a non-title match, which doesn't diminish for a moment the fact that this son of a gun is one we've been looking forward to. Should be a dandy. Muscle Man out of the Motor City whipped across. Big flying press on. Can you see 240 of nothing but solid muscles sailing at you, Dave?
Ooh. Scott Steiner with the left arm, working on that now. By the way, we got a champion on the other side of the ring, too, in all fairness to him.
Yes.
Phil Hickerson does hold the CWA Southern Heavyweight title, and Brickhouse, a former holder of that same belt.
Uh-huh.
Definitely a championship-caliber wrestling match here. Billy Travis with the cover. Couldn't make it stick past the one count. Look at them flying through the air at each other. Billy Travis comes up with the advantage with a bar on Bunkhouse Brown's left arm. I don't know whether to call him Bunkhouse or Brickhouse.
We're calling both before the day.
Yeah, both already have, I think. But anyway, you know who I'm talking about. There's Billy backed into the corner. Down the way, you can see Phil Hickerson standing in his corner, waiting for the tag, which will come later on, I'm sure, from Brickhouse Brown.
Travis pulled himself up short of the turnbuckles in there, out to the center of the ring, and they tie it up. Travis goes to the arm, bends the wrist back. Bunkhouse trying to square up on him where he can get a hold of him, and he does, uses a knee, pow, tag on Phil Hickerson. And Billy takes him straight over and down, hooks up the arm. Hickerson takes him over, but Travis able to hold on to it, and he still has the advantage on the arm bar.
Hickerson weighing in at 279. Boy, he's got plenty of weight behind those right hands that he likes to throw from time to time.
I think he's lying. I think he's heavier than that.
I think he is, too. I think he's around 300, but he says 279.
Yeah.
He looks 300 anyway.
Boy. And yet again, we have to say it, who in the world else that big can move the way Hickerson does? He really gets around for a guy who is as big as he is. Scoops Travis, straight up dumps him down. Just kind of threw him like a rag doll down. He bouncing off the turnbuckle comes Bunkhouse. Shoots a forearm into the face, and Travis rolled up one, but Travis with a right hand.
You know, Lance, this right here is professional wrestling at its finest. Phil Hickerson, the CWA heavyweight champion, see? And you got Bunkhouse Brown, our pride and joy, our number one boy. You know what I'm talking about. What we got here, see, is the CWA, the number one wrestling organization in America, see? And what we got is an organization within an organization, the Stud Stable. Downtown Bruno, the official manager of the Stud Stable. We got Phil Hickerson. Like I said, he is a champion in his own right. And hey, by the way, you tell me if I'm right or wrong. Ain't Travis and Steiner supposed to be like the top tag team around here?
Well, they happen to have the Southern Tag Team belt, so I guess that makes them top dog. Yeah.
Well, is this a championship match?
No, it's not a championship match. It's a non-title belt. And Scott Steiner trying to get a three count on Bunkhouse. He got a two count. Bunkhouse zips one to the midsection and dumps Scott Steiner down into the mat.
Lance, I asked you a question. If they're the champions, why don't they have their belts with?
Because it wasn't signed as a title match. Just that simple. If it had been, we'd have had the match on early in the program where we would have had enough time for even a television time.
Why did they sign as a title match?
They didn't come discuss it with you downtown, Bruno. They take care of their business and you take care of yours.
I take care of the stable. I take care of Phil Hickerson and Bunkhouse Brown. I do it for Robert Fuller. See, he asked me to do it. And nobody came to me about signing this match or anything, about being a title match or a non-title match or whatever, see. Because if they would have came to me, I would have made sure, I'd have made good and sure that it was a title match, and we wouldn't have wrestled these two punks. In other words, Phil and Bunkhouse are beating up these two punks for nothing. It's like a free beating because there's no title on the line. With no title on the line, we can't make that big mega bucks money. Oh, we're going to get paid. We're going to make a lot of money, but not like we would if the titles were on the line.
Whoa, look at that. Monkey flip with Phil Hickerson. Boy, a guy never ceases to amaze me, Dave.
He, in fact, is quick. Scott Steiner being picked up by the hair. Referee is warning Hickerson about that, but he breaks before disqualification. The tag had been made, and Brickhouse Brown is in.
You know what, guys? You know what?
I bet Steiner wishes he had a body like Phil Hickerson. I bet Steiner wishes he had that kind of body right there, see? That's a wrestler's body. That's the kind of body. You can't get that man down off his feet. You can't make that man give up. Steiner's got that imitation muscle, see what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
What, he can't afford a razor blade or something? He can't shave? Look at him. He's all scruffy and bummy looking. You know, I'm always clean shaved. I always look real nice. Got my nice suit on here. Got Phil and Bunkhouse. They're always dapper. Dapper like always. Good looking.
Big elbow from Brown right upside the head of Scott Steiner. Steiner, two-time All-American from the University of Michigan College Wrestling. And his brother was also an All-American at University of Michigan. He is in there now with Bunkhouse Brown. Big knee puts Bunkhouse back down on the deck.
Boy, he hit him coming off those ropes and got that knee in perfect position. Here is Billy Travis in after the tag. Bunkhouse takes a right hand, goes down to the mat. Billy over to the corner. He takes a shot at Phil Hickerson.
One.
Just for good measure, he's got a count of two. Yeah, only a two count.
Left shoulder came popping up there, and he did, in fact, get a good clean two, but he couldn't get the three. Look at Travis wearing out that arm on Brickhouse.
Good pressure on that shoulder, and Bunkhouse Brown screaming. In some pain there as Billy works on that arm and shoulder.
Our time running down. We've got a couple of minutes left in our studio time, and that is all. Woo! Steiner comes across and rattles Phil Hickerson. Travis's head slammed into that top turnbuckle. Bunkhouse drilling him. Drops with an elbow on Travis. Two count only, Dave.
Yep, that's all he was able to get is a two count. Bunkhouse quickly back on Billy Travis.
We've had several of those two counts, but that's it. That doesn't mean a thing. Woo!
Who do you think he is, Mike Tyson? This is a wrestler.
Travis drill him.
Oh, what we got here? There wasn't no tag.
They're all in there. Hickerson and Steiner going at each other. Travis and Bunkhouse across the way. Hickerson and Steiner down on the floor.
Travis out.
Yeah, Travis threw him out. Now everybody's down on the floor. The referee is counting.
Double count out, Dave. Okay, we're out of time. Boy, and I'm telling you, this son of a gun ended up in a double count out. As bodies flying everywhere, Steiner tees off one more time on Bunkhouse. And it is going to end up with no particular victory for anybody, as it's a double count out there. We're all on the floor when it's all over with. David, we got to get out of here. We'll see him next week.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah. Till then, for Dave Brown, Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of Championship Wrestling.